In Enterprise Data Management Cloud, service administrators administer the entire service and have full access to all service data. Everyone else is a user. Allowed actions and data access for users are controlled by assigning a combination of application roles and data permissions. In this overview, we'll show you what you can do as a user with a combination of owner permissions and creator roles. To get started with tasks for other types of users, see our related overviews. This is Alex. He creates and manages multiple applications in the system. He was assigned the application creator and view creator roles so he can create applications and views. Alex can register new applications on the applications page. The system provides packaged application types plus a universal application type for any other business application. The registration process creates default application objects. These include one or more registered dimensions, a viewpoint and data chain objects for each dimension, and a default view, which is composed of dimension viewpoints. Let's start with views. A critical task for a user like Alex is managing the views he owns and setting up new views where users consume application data. Alex can inspect a view he owns to edit metadata, like which users can see the view. He can add or remove viewpoints from views, and add or remove other view owners. He can create views with viewpoints where users can browse or edit data. He can also set up views with viewpoints from multiple applications where users can compare and share data across applications. Before discussing other tasks, it's helpful to understand the application objects and how they relate to each other. Dimensions represent a dimension, segment values, or other data domains in the external application. During registration, dimensions are bound to a default viewpoint which contains the dimension's data. Viewpoints are part of a dimension's data chain. They surface dimension data using a combination of node types, hierarchy sets, and node sets. Node types are a collection of an application's nodes that share a common business purpose. Hierarchy sets define the parent-child relationships between nodes. And node sets define the group of nodes available in viewpoints. One of the most important tasks for an application owner is managing data access by granting permissions to other users or groups. Alex automatically gets owner permissions for the applications he creates. This permission cascades down to everything in the application. He also manages other applications that he didn't create. In those cases, he was granted owner permissions by another owner or a service administrator. Alex can grant data access at the application level by inspecting the application and going to the Permissions tab. He can also grant data access at the dimension level, control what types of actions users can perform at the node type and hierarchy set level, and configure which properties users can view or edit. The inspectors for each object type has a tab for setting permissions. Another important task for owners is setting up policies for data in their applications. There are three types of policies. Approval policies govern the workflow for data changes. Commit policies provide a final review stage for requests before committing changes in order to enforce a segregation of duties. And notification policies enable users to receive email notifications when a completed request is submitted by other users. Policies can be implemented at the application, dimension, hierarchy set, and node type level. The inspectors for each object type has a tab for managing policies. Application owners typically manage the data integrity for their applications. When the system validates data, there are three types of validation checks that may apply: system level checks, which apply to all data; application specific validations, which apply to data for packaged application types; and custom validations, which owners can define for node types and hierarchy sets for all application types. Let's look at dimension management tasks. To inspect a dimension, go to the Dimensions tab in the Application Inspector, then click a dimension. Owners manage dimension bindings, that is, the viewpoint the dimension is bound to, and map bindings. Dimension bindings preserve the data integrity of the dimension. Users can only import data to or export data from bound viewpoints. A bound viewpoint essentially represents the version of the dimension that matches the external application. Map bindings are used to map node types from different source and target systems. Alex can create map bindings on this tab. Alex can manage import and export settings for the dimension on the Import/Export tab. On the Extracts tab for a dimension, Alex can define extracts to extract any viewpoint related to that dimension, regardless of its binding status. Extracts let owners set up more flexible extract options than are available in a standard dimension export, such as which properties to include, filtered results, and file and data format options. On the Validations tab, Alex can manage the application-specific validation rules for a dimension by enabling or disabling them for the bound viewpoint. Next, let's look at data chain management tasks for owners. Remember, registering an application creates a default node type, hierarchy set, and node set for each dimension. Alex can manage those or create new ones from their respective pages. The node type inspector is where Alex can manage which properties are available for the node type. Each node type is described by one or more properties. For example, name, description, data storage, data type, and alias are all properties. The Converters tab is where he defines node type converters, rules to convert a node type to another node type, which are used to share nodes across applications. And the Validations tab is where he can create custom validation rules for the node type. There's a similar tab in the Hierarchy Set inspector. The Data Chain tab lets any user see and easily navigate to data chain objects that are related to the current one. On the Definition tab of the Hierarchy Set inspector, owners define which node types are included in the hierarchy and the parent-child relationships between them. In this mapping hierarchy, acquired account node types can't be used as parent nodes. This is also where shared nodes are enabled for the hierarchy. Although application properties are created by default, owners can manage which properties are used in their application and how they behave. Use the search bar to search for a specific property. Properties are assigned to node types, and a single property may be used across multiple node types. Node types that use the property are listed by application. Each property has a set of base parameters. Owners can define custom parameters at the application or node type level. For example, Alex can change this alias property at the application level by adding a custom expression so all node types in the application derive their aliases from the core description property. Finally, owners can create lookup sets, which can be referenced in custom expressions. Lookup sets transform a set of values for properties into a different set of values. Check the description for links to related videos and the Manage and Govern Enterprise Data Assets with Enterprise Data Management Cloud Learning Series. To learn more, visit docs.oracle.com.